I definitely have some explaining to do. Behind me here is what used to be a 1990 Mazda Miata, but now it's in the process of becoming a death cart. But before we get into it, I have to explain why the car looks like that right now. So backtrack 2 days ago, we got the Miata and we started taking it apart. We took off the windshield, that was the main thing, started taking out the interior panels, started taking off the doors, trunk, everything like that. Basically dissecting the car. And of course I was recording everything to show you guys, but somehow, and I don't know how I did this, but I lowered the quality on the camera and all the footage came out like complete trash. But here are the clips from 2 days ago. You guys will understand what I'm talking about the bad quality, and you guys will semi get up to date. So bros, we got a 1990 Mazda Miata. It's an absolute piece of shit. We know that. There's no front end, there's no motor, there's no transmission, but we don't need any of that. For $200, it's not bad at all. Everything that we need is pretty much in the car. We're gonna use the dash, the steering wheel maybe, but this car is all gonna get chopped up. Yeah, let me just get inside the Miata.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Ah! Oh, yo! It actually moved up though.
2, 1.
Oh, Jay's weaker than me. Jay's weaker than me.
What?
My size out, dude.
Holy shit.
Oh. Oh shit, yeah. Dude, windshield is off and it's actually starting to look like a death cart now.
2 days later.
I know the clips are pretty brutal to watch and I'm so sorry. From here on out, I'm gonna make sure that doesn't happen again. So with the Miata, we took off the doors and now we're Jeep status. We also took off the front windshield and we kind of fucked it up while we were at it. In the interior, we didn't do much yet. We just took off like carpeting, the seat belts. We still have to take off the center stuff there. Definitely gonna be selling the steering wheel, but what we are keeping is the dash and the gauges. And for 1990, these gauges are in pretty good condition and the dash isn't cracked at all, which I'm really hyped about. The seats are definitely getting swapped out because the last person must have took a toxic ass rip in this seat. So in this car, there's no motor, no trans, no diff, no drive shaft. We pretty much just bought a rolling shell. You guys are probably thinking, we? Who's we? Well, I bought a car with the one and only Jay Krua, aka officially Rice, aka the guy who drives the Auto 86.
Not for long though. Not for long.
Fuck you. What? All right, let me just, so he has to plug that wire into that and... Dude, we can move the Miata out of the way if you want. Do you want me to hold it down for you at least? While he's trying to kill himself, I'll just explain the story. We're gonna be putting a stock Miata motor in here. Miata trans, Miata everything, because they're all direct fits. We've never dealt with a motor before. We've never dealt with a motor swap or anything like that. So to keep it simple and ensure that we do everything semi-correctly, we're just gonna keep everything Miata.
Dude, that's so fucking sketchy.
What if I just gave the car a good kick? But like I was saying, everything for now is gonna stay Miata. But who knows, in the future we might go 2J, SR, LS. I personally wanna go LS, but we might do something crazy like that.
We also made a list of things that we have to do. Motor, trans, diff, coils, wheels, cage. We definitely have to get a key because this car has no key. So the steering doesn't turn. We kind of have to just lift it and move it. We also have to fix the rust because this is kind of a rusty shit box right now. Dip or possibly paint bag. Dude, we're not doing bags. We're doing coils. Also, the Miata doesn't have a name. We want to put a name here.
If you guys have a name in mind, definitely leave it down in the comments. While Jay's in there making plenty of noise, I'm gonna explain what I'm gonna be doing and what he's gonna be doing today.
So I already went ahead and sanded this entire door down, primered pretty much all of it. I have to fix the primer a little bit over here, but I primered pretty much the entire door. We're also gonna be doing this door today. So I'm gonna sand this door completely down, mask off the glass, mask off this, and primer it.
So while I'm gonna be sanding and primering, Jay's gonna be over here cutting off the rear quarter panel
from here and take all this off. And from here on back, we don't need anything. So all this is gonna be gone, hopefully by today. All this is gonna be gone. Same thing on the other side. And possibly this little tower thing.
She's right ahead.
Car for exactly $100, and this is the most fun car I've ever had, mainly for this reason.
Huge shout out to Sideways Fab for heavily inspiring this build.
Obviously, since Sideways Fab kind of inspired this build, it's gonna look a lot like his, and it's also gonna look a lot like the Hoonigan's death car. I know they're making one too. Theirs is probably gonna come out a little bit better than ours. We're doing it in our garage. We have absolutely no idea what we're doing. We could easily take it to a shop and get it done, but we kind of want to do it ourselves, experience it for ourselves, and if we show you guys the whole process, maybe you guys might be able to do it too.
Do you think that with one whack, do you think I could get through the metal?
One whack?
One whack. Like right here. Not with the back end. With the front end. Do you think that I could get through the metal?
No.
You don't think so?
I don't think so.
Damn. All right, let me get one more shot.
Damn, weak boy. Damn, weak boy.
Damn. All
right, I'm gonna make a hole right now, watch.
You think?
Oh shit,
I made a
yo.
Hole. Clean ass hole, bro. I'm just nice like that.
I did this on the BRZ, like I had like so much regret, like I was like, oh, I don't know if I want to do it. Uh-huh. But with this car, I'm just like, fuck it, like I don't even care.
Oh yeah, of course.
All right, so quick update time. With the door, it's fully sanded and primed. Now all we have left is the trunk. The back of the car is completely gone.
Whatever we left is what we couldn't do. Like around here, I didn't want to mess with the fuel lines with the angle grinder. So we're gonna come back with an electric saw another day and cut all that off. But I cut it off from there. We cut it all back here. This we have to come back and do with the saw because it's too deep for the angle grinder. But dude, this is like, it's a beautiful mess, to be honest.
It looks like a mess. But it's beautiful because this mess has so much potential.
I think we're gonna call it a day for cutting. We cut a lot today. We have a lot of garbage. I'm loading up the garbage into the minivan. We're gonna go throw away all this metal, plastic, bumper, and everything. Jay's putting on his stocks because we might go drifting today.